sitting outside the classroom waiting to go in, and I saw an airplane hit the tower of a TV. You know, the TV was obviously on, and I used to fly myself, and I said, well, there's one terrible pilot.
Well, as I was walking down the street, I happened to hear like an engine sound, and the plane was like, as if it was going really fast, and I didn't think of anything, so I kept on walking. All of a sudden, you heard a loud explosion, so we all ran.
But other than that, it's kind of quiet around the country. We like quiet. It's quiet. It's too quiet. That's a quick. And we have learned a couple of things this morning. In fact, we're starting a new feature. First of all, we've noticed that for some reason, several people in our audience have worn various shades of purple. Just by coincidence, did you all call each other and plan this?
No.
And even...
Thank you. Back here in New York, where reports now that two more buildings at the World Trade Center complex are burning now and in danger of collapsing. Two more buildings. The fires are said to be in buildings 7 and 5. This morning, it was towers 1 and 2 that were hit by the airplanes that collapsed. There are now fears of more fire and possible collapse in buildings 7 and 5.
Right, something some people might not know. The World Trade Center is actually a complex of a total of 7 buildings, of which the two most prominent were. It's a way of gathering even more innocent victims.
Mary and Jim, I have another update for you right now. This was handed to me. 7 World Trade Center, which is located on Betsy Street. It's a 60-story building. Firefighters on the scene say that building is right now severely leaning towards the south.
In the meantime, however, the Israeli government is said by sources to believe that Osama bin Laden is responsible for the operation. And those two organizations are related, but they are not exactly the same.
Reporting and speculating is that there is only one terror organization in this world that could coordinate this kind of event, and that would be something operated by Osama bin Laden. Intelligence officials say he is in Afghanistan, where he has been protected by the Taliban. And as we know, the United States has...
Okay.
Well, let's go to Paul Bremer now. Ambassador Paul Bremer, who's the chairman of the National Commission on Terrorism. Mr. Ambassador, do we have any idea whatsoever who may be responsible for this?
Probably are four possible candidates. There's the Osama bin Laden Al-Qaeda group that you've been talking about.
Just at this moment, you're a terrorism expert.
Counterterrorism, I hope.
And can talk to us a little bit about who could, I mean, there are a limited number of groups who could be responsible for something of this magnitude.
Yes, this is a very well planned, very well coordinated attack, which suggests it's very well organized centrally. And there are only three or four candidates in the world really who conducted this attack.
Bin Laden comes to mind right away, Mr. Bremer.
Indeed, he certainly does. Bin Laden was involved in the first attack on the World Trade Center, which...
The east as well and slightly north, so air traffic, obviously it's a congested area, although that was restricted airspace. No planes fly that close to New York.
Landing here at the bottom is somewhere in lower Manhattan. It was December 7th, 1941, actually the next day, that FDR said this is a day that shall live in infamy.
And people on every street corner, it was like a movie, but you watched the planes hit the towers.
I was watching with my roommate. It was approximately several minutes after the first plane had hit. I saw this plane come out of nowhere and just ream right into the side of the Twin Tower, exploding through the other side. And then I witnessed both towers collapse, one first and then the second, mostly due to structural failure because the fire was just too intense.
Obviously, there were a lot of people inside the buildings at the time.
From the 7th Precinct, the 1st Precinct, the fire department right here, the 7th truck, those guys were all right there at ground zero when those things went down. And God bless, I know there's a lot of guys there that were around there, and hopefully they made it out.
What was happening?
When the next building blew up. And then all of a sudden, everybody's in stand. Everyone's running all over the place, the panic attack. Then after a few while later, all of a sudden, people are running hysterical, and we go to look, and the building collapsed. So we're running, and we're trying to
That's
run against...
A long time later, the building collapsed. People have been running all morning.
Work this morning. If you look behind me, you can see the very remains, the skeletal remains of the World Trade Center. And one volunteer, Robert Gerlinski, explained to me the reason there's so little rubble is that all of it simply fell down into the ground and was pulverized, evaporated. Now I should say though, for the last several hours, there's been
beams that are here that are restrained from expanding, prevented from expanding because of this column here, for example, that can buckle. And you see an example of a buckled beam right here.
On September 10th, I arrived around noon, went upstairs, there was no one there, started working. But I believe Monica was there. She had the cameras out the window, so she was there.
During the time that the airplane coming in to the Pentagon, there was a young man who would come in and say to the vice president, the plane is 50 miles out, the plane is 30 miles out. And when it got down to the plane is 10 miles out, the young man also said to the vice president, do the orders still stand? And the vice president turned and whipped his neck around and said, of course the orders still stand. Have you heard anything to the contrary? Well, at the time, I didn't know what all that meant. And
the flight you're referring to is
the flight that came into the Pentagon.
Enormous numbers of us. We see all of this video and these live pictures of where the towers used to stand, but the question is, where is all the rubble? It seems so flattened. How could so much steel and concrete just vaporize? Did it all turn to dust?
$5 billion of insurance coverage on the WTC complex, which earlier that year had been valued at $1.2 billion. Silverstein had insisted on doubling that amount, insuring the buildings for $3.55 billion. Silverstein's insurance broker struggled to put that much coverage in place and ultimately had to split it among 25 dealers.
Of a plane having crashed anywhere near the Pentagon. The only site is the actual side of the building that's crashed in. And as I said, the only pieces left that you can see are small enough that you could pick up in your hand. There are no large tail sections, wings.
Affiliate of Fox affiliate. He was back there just a couple of minutes ago. And Chris, I've seen the pictures. It looks like there's nothing there except for a hole in the ground.
Basically, that's right. The only thing you could see from where we were was a big gouge in the earth and some broken trees. We could see some people walking around in the area, but from where we could see, there wasn't much left.
Any large pieces of debris at all?
No, there was nothing that you could distinguish that a plane had crashed there.
Smoke, fire?
Nothing, it was absolutely quiet. It was,
Whoa.
is America.
Okay.
That you slipping
up. Let's go.
Look how I'm living up. Police be tripping up. Yeah. This is America.
Go low to the corner.
Guns in my area. I got the strap.
I gotta carry it.
Contraband. I got the plug on a hawker.